talk about fluorocarbon for hook lengths and possibly mainline as well. And mate of mine, Miles, he uses it a lot more than I do. I tend to use it for combi rigs and stuff,
sure.
But I don't use it as the main hook length a lot of the time, I must be honest. I tend to use coated hook lengths a lot, you know. But you use it virtually all the time, don't you?
Well, I certainly use it as a mainline. Yeah. A lot of my fishing at the moment and over the last few years has been on sort of fairly small waters. Quite tricky, they're weedy, which means they're clear.
Yeah.
And so the benefits of fluorocarbon really come through there. And I like the way it sinks down and so on. I wouldn't use it really for fishing beyond 75 yards. I feel that mono will be at such a shallow angle at that sort of range that the fluorocarbon's not necessary. And to be honest, once you're getting beyond that sort of distance, fluorocarbon is a bit tougher to cast anyway.
It is, isn't it? When I've used it, you can hear it chafing off the reel, can't you?
It's a bit wirier and so on. Yeah. But I think one great tip is to pull off an amount of line. Mm. Just keeping fluorocarbon on the spool of your reel means it gets a bit coiled up. So what I tend to do is try and find a path or a straight bit of bank, put my lead in a tree, or you'll always find somewhere, use your bivvy peg, and then give it a bit of a stretch out, and then wind it back on gently, certainly under some pressure, and then it behaves a hell of a lot better. That's quite a nice tip, I think. And something you've talked about already today is keeping your line clean as well.
Yeah, it's very important, isn't it?
Yeah. For casting, and I mean, what's the point in having a fluorocarbon that sort of disappears, if you like, in water, and then you allow it to get covered in algae and all the other bits in the water, and then you might as well have some tow rope on there.
That's right. Yeah, it really does show, doesn't it, when it's got all that scum on it and everything.
Yeah,
bottom's breaking up.
Yeah.
So how do you clean it? Just through a damp cloth?
I always used to use a damp cloth, but the available now are alcohol wipes. You have to be careful which ones you buy, because a lot of alcohol wipes have moisturisers and perfumes and other things in there. But you can buy little alcohol wipes that have nothing in there, purely alcohol, and they clean them off. The other place to go to is actually fly fishing shops.
Right,
because in fly fishing, a fly line needs to come out through the rings really nice and easily, and fly fishermen spend a lot of time keeping their line in good nick, and they will clean their line off with these really nice pads that have, you know, great products and whatnot in them. And then they'll dress their line with silicons and things afterwards, which is a bit like us putting silicon on for distance casting.
Yeah.
So, taking care of your lines is really important. One of the things people struggle with is the right knot in fluorocarbon.
Yeah, yeah.
I always used to think the Palomar knot was the right one to use, until I did some tests on a machine, and then I looked more and more into it, and I found some quite interesting things by some line manufacturers in the States. And a clinch knot, or a blood knot, whatever you like to call it, that actually is a stronger knot in fluorocarbons. And that I found interesting, because I'd always used a Palomar knot and told the whole world that was the right one to use. But now I've done the test and read it as well, I think that is the one. But what knot, when you use it for the stiff boom for a combi rig, do you?
That's right, yeah.
And what knot do you use at the end of there, an Albright or something?
An Albright is my favourite knot for that, yeah. It's absolutely bulletproof.
Yeah, that's right.
And you can do a very, very short combi link with that as well.
Exactly,
which is a lot of people struggle with other knots with it.
Yeah.
But with the Albright, as I say, you can use the end, braid of your choice.
Yeah.
That gives the bait movement and everything.
Sure.
And the Albright's easily the best.
And what do you do at the other end of the boom, so where you're joining onto the swivel?
Well, at the end? I'm a bit of a, I suppose, a heathen like that. I don't do loops or anything like that, like some people do. I just have an anti-tangle boom and use it on a safety clip normally.
I mean, it's going to kick away really nicely then, isn't it?
Yeah, it does kick away with that. You know, as it falls, that little boom seems to just flatten it off.
But you'd want to fish that with a slow sinking, sort of critically balanced or wafting sort of bait.
Yeah,
if you put two big 20 millers on there, it might all just bend up in
that's
the middle.
Right. I mean, do you use it for stiff rigs? Do you ever use stiff rigs anymore?
No. To be honest, no. I use it like you as a boom for to be honest, if I'm using a fluorocarbon type material all the way through, then I'll use mono. I find the extra stretch in mono allows me to use a finer diameter, and the presentation for me is a bit better. That's my personal thought. So if I'm using mono from the swivel all the way through the hook and the hair, then I'll use mono and not fluorocarbon.
Have you ever tested, say, using tiger nuts or something, and you use nylon all the way through?
Yep.
Depending on how you tie them, you can have it so the rig actually hangs upside down and the hooks.
That's right.
Have you seen that?
Yeah, I have. Yeah. I've looked at that, and the other thing a chap Gary Pete showed me was having mono and the knotless knot, but then having a supple braid made out of some sort of 4 or 6 pound hair.
That's where I was going with it. Yeah. A lot of people, if they use it with the knotless knot straight way through, if you do tank tests or test it in the margins, you'll see that the hook hangs upside down.
It goes
completely wrong.
That's right.
You're going to miss fish like that.
Yeah, yeah.
So the answer always is to use a supple braided hair.
Exactly.
It's a bit more fiddly, but if you go to that trouble, it'll present perfect every time.
Yeah,
a lot of people don't realise that.
No. So with fluorocarbon or mono, if you're making hook links out of it, either a combi as we prefer, or if you're going to use it for the knotless knot as well, then you've got to make that hair supple, haven't
that's
you?
That's right. Yeah.
But for me, fluorocarbon, the clarity of it is, I think, a great benefit. For me, it's more the fact that it sinks so damn quickly. I have my ideas and thoughts on what fish can see, and I think their barbels and their pec fins and what they feel is, to be honest, probably, to me, is more important with making all that disappear. But, you know, we as anglers all have different thoughts, and that's great.
Well, let's face it, if you go to the ninth degree with everything, make it absolutely as inconspicuous as possible, percentages wise it's going to work, isn't it? So the more you can do it, the better it's going to be.
That's really. And I think the fluorocarbons that we use really do help
that.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Excellent.